remember everything you know about screwdrivers. You're gonna need all of it.
The screwdriver was invented in 2 AD
by a caveman named Mon. It looked pretty much the same as the screwdriver you see today. Because it hasn't needed to evolve. I mean, who doesn't still love that beautiful red handle, or blue, or yellow, on a screwdriver? Huh. Screws have changed.
It's 280.
Actually,
an alarmingly steady rate. But that's neither here.
We use screwdrivers today to screw a lot of things. Door handles.
Help!
Watches.
Help!
At one point
during the Great Screwdriver Battle of 1812, it was said,
without screwdriver,
there is no humanity.
Because of this,
when people realized the importance of screwdrivers, some were driven mad. Thus began the fad of the screwdriver, alcoholic drink. Aptly named because orange juice, vodka, were very much in the style of the time.
Anyway, since then,
screwdrivers have become quite controversial. The Mormons, in particular, because they use a lot of screwdrivers, they build a lot of things, but then also, they don't like alcohol. So, it's been a lot.
I think that
end it there. Okay. Q&A.
So screwdriver as a drink was starting to be used during brunches in the 1850s. So do even at this time in history do brunches still fall on a Sunday?
You bring up a really excellent point. I'm glad you asked that. It's really interesting, actually. They used to fall on a Sunday, the very origin.
And then there was,
at some point, like 50 years into the tradition, this big political uprising. And they decided that Sunday could no longer be. They didn't want to associate brunch with the holy day because they decided they should always fast on the holy day. So the religious community could no longer celebrate brunch on that Sunday. So a lot of them opted to move to Saturday, and eventually just for convenience sakes, and the restaurants didn't want to have to do the like two brunch specials a week. So they kind of moved it back to Saturdays for a while. But now, you know the tea partiers,
mm-hmm.
So when they came back around, then they were upset about that the church influenced the state in that way.
So they said, you know what?
As we're revolution, we're going back. We're gonna make it Sundays again. We're gonna stand up to the church and say, enough's enough. Brunch is on Sunday.
Thank you.
Bless up.
Oh, did you have a question as well?
Yeah. How do you distinguish a screwdriver from a screwdriver?
Oh, from the beverage, from the tool. Yeah. So actually, we start teaching this at a very early age. I recommend 6 years old. Because you really want to get their liver adjusted to the vodka at an early age, you know, to be a responsible parent. And, you know, they've been using the tool forever, right? Because you use your first screwdriver around to write a passage about, like, 2 months in. Yeah. I digress.
I firmly believe that you need to teach the difference
at least 6 years old. Because otherwise, they'll be confused. You don't want them to drink the tool, is really what I'm getting at here. That would be a mistake. And that's how you get a lot of toddler age deaths. That would be. But.
RIP. Yeah. Beautiful.